Mahesh ji, 30 years journey with an organization where you are heading business and taking entrepreneurship to a new level. How has this journey been? What has been your most important learnings?
Thank you, Rajesh ji. It's an amazing journey, I can say. I mean, everybody feels that yes, I have achieved something, but then for me, it's truly a beginning and a long way to go from here. But in this process, we always say learning is a process and which is ever ending. And truly, I've been learning many things, and today I feel, yes, I know a bit of it, which will definitely help me to take this organization to the next level. So it's a wonderful journey, I can say.
So I think in the year 2003, when the turnover started, the actual the turning point of the organization as well as for you happened during your one of your international learning exposures that you did at Wharton. Did your mindset change after that?
Yes, of course, because I believe into learning, which because of that I keep reading books, interacting with people, attending these kind of sessions and studying. And that is one of the part of it in 2003, because I chose to do the ISB Wharton program, where 3 weeks we were in Hyderabad, the ISB campus, and then 3 weeks in Wharton. And I must say, in true sense, that was the time where I got exposure in terms of the wealth creation process, which is called, because you know, value creation. Then I realized, we earn profit out of the business is one, but to creating the wealth out of, because your shares, which because normally, because if you keep it in the cupboard, because after so many years, because probably they turn into yellow and because not worth even holding in your hand. But then how do we create value for that? So that is an amazing experience where I got exposure and which I started working, because 3 onwards I said, yes, I think, no, looking back now, I think, how do we? So then you have to reach to the people. So we started, because, you know, going to the places like Bangalore and Chennai and Ahmedabad, many places. Otherwise, we were predominantly working into Mumbai, Pune. So one is exposure of that, and then because experience, because you are working, because that was a combination of two, which gave us edge to the organization to really compete with the peers in the market, and then slowly start creating the valuation. So people started looking at you. Why will anybody, I always use the term, because we started maturing ourselves and people started noticing us. So that was the process. And then because in 2003, after I came back from there, you know, because I started, how do I begin? Because who are the people from the industry? Whom should I look upon, and how do I learn from them? So big companies like L&T's and Shapuji's, Billy Murray, because 3 companies were there. I said, why are they big? Why are they different? And institutions like HDFC and bankers. And so that is how I started, you know, interacting with people. And that journey has been very, very interesting.
What do you believe as a part of team building? Because you're in a line of business where your success, like every other business, but more so in your business, depends on your core team. So what do you do to select your team and how do you empower them?
See, we very easily talk this term of team work, team spirit. But in true sense, to put it, it is very difficult. One has got to deal with your people with a lot of affection. And family we do with our own, because brothers, sisters we do, and we try and, you know, because understand them. At times they are wrong, because still we could try and, because, you know, take them along with us. When it comes to organization, because then when you are growing on the on the growth path, then most of the time people think that this I know factor because it truly brings you down. So in my case, because as you rightly gave that example, so such a wonderful example, probably because it can go in one of the best case studies. This boy was so good, because before my marriage, I used to go very frequently there for my lunch. And with always smile on his face. In fact, today also if you meet him, because this guy, I have never seen him because in those kind of, you know, making faces or problems. And I used to like something, say, because I like this, or I like crispy roti, because I like that my water glass to be clean, I like this. And he understood me, and whenever I used to go with smiling face, he used to come and serve me, talk to me nicely. And that gave me because very good feeling, and then I started talking with him. Then I told one day, because why don't you, because are you happy with this? Sir, happy, abhi gaon se aaya to yahan pe happy rehna padega. So would you like to come, because in our organization? तो क्या करना है सर, हमारा कैंटीन है, उसका तुम देखो कुछ भी. And from that, because this boy started taking interest, because, you know, became, because the courier, because the looking boy, or Xerox, those used to be there, then operator job. Today, because as Rajesh told, because he is, because whole and soul, because such a trusted person, because we call him like a fire brigade of company, because 24/7, anything you tell, this boy doesn't know, because he'll never say no, or because I don't know. Yes, sir. Yes, sir, and because he'll see that it is happening, no Sundays, no holidays, no nothing. So this loyalty comes out of, because your kind of affection, you have to treat them like that. So the moment, because it's give and take in life, because you take people along with you, I think I always say, leader is the one when he's walking and he looks behind, there has to be crowd behind him. You can't be a lone leader.
How do you use the funds that come into your organization, deploying it the right way? And I'm sure that HDFC card helped the organization grow as well.
100%. You know, as Rajeshji told, getting money was one like challenge, but then after coming, it was the biggest challenge. Because I always think we are always in this kind of position at a fiduciary capacity. Because you can't say that this is my money, because it's somebody else's money. You got to deal with very due diligent way. And you got to give that kind of importance to that. We have to very carefully manage that money. And because we started thinking, what do we do? Where do we utilize and how do we? Because some portion of money we started utilizing to bring the growth. So that is how we reached sometime 2012 range, because 4 years it took around 500, 600 crore, which we have been maintaining and was growing, because every year by 100 crore, 150 crore. But again, investing money and doing contracting is also not good business, because we have to always, you know, because do the business with, I always call within the organization, OPM, other people's money, because you can't put your money and do the business. That is smartness, because creditors, how you to utilize creditors' money, there because credit worthiness, because we have been there for a donkey's number of years, and with that kind of credibility. And clients, we have been enjoying very good reputation. So upfront, I asked them about, so money for your job, because my job is to give the delivery, the best quality, speed, and then best budget. Money you have to pay. So we don't try and put our money. So this money, because we started using, so we've been working for all these developers all over the country. We got such a rich experience. We created our brand. Why don't we create backward integration for ourselves? So that is how this process started. And then we started looking out for opportunities in, because the metro cities, and luckily we came across this. I did not waste the time, because one stroke, one deal, 170 crore we paid, got the registration done. It's a clean, clear-cut property. Because it is impossible to get in this city, because, you know, they always come with some tags along with that. So absolute clean property today, because Rajesh told that we are in the process of drawing board, because the architects are working. Probably a couple of months down the line, we should be talking about the launch of the project. And no doubt, I think it shouldn't amount to me making big statement, but then it will be one of the best, because 70 years we have ourselves, because put that kind of experience, we have learned so many things, which we'll try and put into our own baby and make the best out of it.
So it speaks volumes about identifying the right customers, because I have seen the profile. You have selected very, very nicely. It is like matchmaking, like getting married to a girl. You have made sure that you have not done it with the wrong party. You have selected the right people. What do you do? What is that extra mile that you go to make sure that the customers are always retaining by you? Are retained by you?
Here, I think, Rajesh, I must definitely give due credit to our chairman, who is 81 year old today. His, you know, professional upbringing, value-based business systems, ethical business systems, and the relationship. Because we give a lot of importance to relationship, because end of the day, your reputation is more important than money. If people believe into you, money will come. So we never take any shortcuts, and we never try to jump into the taking the contract. So we are very choosy, very selective. We discuss probably, I must say, because one of the few contractors where whenever I'm discussing about any project, when we come to fag end, I do not hesitate to talk to a client, sir, let me know, because from where this funding of this project is going to be. Sometimes they like, they do not like. But then I say, sir, because I'm not asking myself for upke project, you want to do this project in time? You want to do this kind of quality, So I must know from where money is coming, because if I stop the project, more than you, because it's a credibility to my organization. People say, hey, contractor ka kaam, because who NCC is doing work is not happening. So I take them into confidence. If projects are good, I go to the extent of helping them to get the money organized. Sometimes they do not have those kind of resources. We have, because I'm socially very well connected. I love meeting people. I love making friends. And
he is also on the board of a couple of funds. Please make a note of that when you interact with him.
So, you know, that helps greatly to, you know, give the business to each other and look after your company's interests also. So I think honest is the best policy, because if you are honest, I think people understand you in long term.
Does your honesty cost a little more to the customers in terms of contract pricing?
Not really, truly speaking.
Or you're competitive, even if they're old customers.
We are very, very competitive, because in long run, you know, you may, because people may find it on the face of it, maybe a little higher, you know, compared to because any other contractor. But in long run, in terms of, we don't cheat them on quality. Your product is being delivered to you faster. So cash flow for them is faster. So you may feel that 5% somebody is quoting low, but if he's delaying your project by 12 months, you can imagine that cash flow hit. So people, they understand, that is how they come repeatedly. We have been working with clients like Prestige or Piramals or Bagmane from Bangalore. Many of the companies, you know, multinational companies, for 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 years. So you can imagine how could this happen. Otherwise, in contracting, one contract and that's end of it.
Sometimes people have three contractors in one project.
No. End of the contract, there is some dispute, there is some argument, there is some claim, and you know, you are ending up with some sort of, you know,
compromise.
And then you have no issue, otherwise there is no option but to do that. But then in our case, we don't get into that.
How do you depend on innovation, and what is the process of getting innovation in your working?
Today, you know, we keep talking about technology. So in-house as well as at site. In-house, if you say, because we come long way there also, from the manual accounting to, because the computerization and some local, those basic and COBOL and those kind of programmings, to now, this is the, I think, first year we started this process almost 5 years back. We have fully implemented the SAP system in our organization in all the modules, whereby we have 42 sites happening all over the country, geographically spread, I said, from Sikkim to Chennai down. Sikkim, Himachal Pradesh, Chandigarh, Uttaranchal, Delhi, Noida, Mumbai, Pune, Bangalore, Ahmedabad. So most of the places, it is impossible in our business to control by sitting here. So with this SAP tool, we have got connected everybody. So then everything is online. People know also, there is no gap about anything. Second, at site, in terms of formwork, in terms of equipments, we have been upgrading on regular basis. So dependency on the laborers, it comes down. So it's a great advantage if you think all the time innovative. N number of products are available. And today, recently, you know, because 6 months back, we have tied on with the JV agreement with the Australian company. Probably we are the first one in India to do the three-dimensional construction technology. This is called 3D technology. Because we have the precast, which is 2D. We have got normal conventional, but this is 3D, where because no joints, and you do such a faster construction, because in 15 days, because you can have the ground plus four-story, 20 apartments building ready. And this is not story, this is not theory, this is not some experience I'm telling, but this is actual, which is happening. We, with this technology, we got the job from Tata Housing at Boisa. We are doing 2,000 apartments. We just started the project 2 months down the line back, and we've been going ahead with extremely good experience there also. I must say one thing, because he spoke about my humility, you know, from these words and this whatever I'm doing now today, a lot of credit goes to him.